Peace. It's not you, and I wanted to do this recording about pH. You know, with all the toxins and carcinogens, you know what I'm saying, being bombarded in the foods that we eat, the liquids that we drink, and even the gases that we breathe, there's been a renewed interest in personal health, a sort of health renaissance. And one of the most important aspects of health is pH. Okay, so what exactly is pH? Well, pH is an acronym that stands for potential for hydrogen. Okay, and what that means is it's the amount of concentrated hydrogen ions in the liquids in our bodies. See, our bodies are biochemical plants. So everything we think, everything we feel, every chemical reaction that takes place in our bodies are being facilitated by electricity. And that electricity is being modulated by our pH. Well, how exactly does our pH modulate that electricity? Well, first, pH operates within a range of 0 to 14 and 7 being neutral. Everything above 7 is alkaline and everything below 7 is acidic. And the hydrogen ions in the liquids in our body modulates the electricity through resistance, through electrical resistance. Now, I'm aware that when I say the word resistance, a lot of people might have negative connotations in their minds around the word resistance. But fundamentally, the purpose of resistance, not only in the blood, but in life in general, is to make energy useful. So let's use an example. You know, if you consider any electrical device like the phone that you might be looking at this recording through, there's little components inside of that device called resistors. And what these resistors do is they actually slow down the flow of electricity in that device. If those resistors weren't there, then the electricity was just freely flowing through, it actually began to burn up the components in there, not making it useful. So again, the purpose of the resistors or resistance is to make energy useful. So in our in our bloodstreams, in the fluids in our bodies, the pH acts as an electrical resistance so that the energy can be useful. Okay, when the fluids in our body are acidic, then the flow of electricity has very little resistance, so there's a lot of rapid and quick electrical activity taking place, and that's what contributes to the burning that we feel. You understand? So if you can imagine a car battery, if any of that, the acid inside of the car battery was to spill on your skin, it would actually cause a burning. You understand? As opposed to if the liquid was alkaline, you know, there's a lot, the electrical activity is a lot slower, so then it creates a cooling effect. Now, I'm pretty sure that you guys are familiar with, you know, elders like Layla Africa or Dr. Sebi, who teaches us that the basis of most of the disease states that we encounter is mucus. However, mucus itself is alkaline, okay? Mucus is an alkaline reaction to the acidic environment in our body. So the acids are actually, you know, saying, creating a burning, very quick and rapid electrical activity, and the mucus actually buffers this burning. And of course, when you have excessive a burning taking place, then you're going to have chronic mucus production. You understand? That's where all the clogging, you understand, takes place within our the various circulatory systems in our body, which is the beginning of disease. Okay, and so there are tiny microorganisms in our bodies, and when they're exposed to an acidic environment, they actually begin to transform. You understand? And begin to aggress against the body. So again, the most important thing in our bodies in terms of the chemical reactions that take place is our pH. And again, pH stands for potential for hydrogen. And we control the pH by the type of foods that we take in, the liquids that we drink, and even the gases that we breathe. I hope this recording was useful to you guys. Be healthy out there. Take care of yourselves and each other. Peace.